Look at the goaltenders, might go at it. Here we go. Brent Johnson with DiPietro. I want to see it. Here we go.
Yo, hit him with a left. He popped. No, you hit him. He's not going to hit him again. But he's going to hold him down and don't let him up.
Well, he hammered him good.
Well, seeing as how at the time of recording this, the Oilers are about to shit the bed in the playoffs, let's talk about Dwayne Roloson. Roloson began his hockey journey in 1990, playing for UMass Lowell of the NCAA. He would spend 4 years as a collegiate standout. Although he was never officially selected in the draft, he was signed to a developmental deal with the Calgary Flames organization in 1994. He would spend 2 full seasons down in the AHL playing for the St. John's Flames, and quickly rose up the ranks and in 1996-97 made his NHL debut for the Calgary Flames. That year appearing in 31 games with a goals against average of 2.89 and a save percentage of .897. He would spend another year in the Calgary Flames organization before being traded to the Buffalo Sabres. He would bounce between the Rochester Americans and the Buffalo Sabres in 98-99, but only playing a handful of games for each. The following year would only see him suit up for 14 games for Buffalo. In 2000-2001, Roloson was picked in the expansion draft by the Columbus Blue Jackets, but rather than playing with the expansion team, he would opt into signing with the AHL team of the St. Louis Blues, the Worcester Ice Cats. That season, Roloson would lead the AHL in goals against, save percentage, shutouts, and wins, and winning the Boz Bastian Memorial Award for the AHL's best goaltender in the process. The following season, he would sign a deal with the Minnesota Wild and play 4 seasons in Minnesota for the Wild. It was at the trade deadline in 2005-2006 that Dwayne Roloson would set his date with destiny as he was traded to the Edmonton Oilers. He would finish out the 19 remaining games of the season for Edmonton, posting a goals against average of 2.43 and a save percentage of .905. The Oilers would make the playoffs, but not too many people would give them a chance against the Detroit Red Wings. The Oilers would knock off the stacked Detroit Red Wings, then consisting of Pavel Datsyuk, Henrik Zetterberg, Brendan Shanahan, Steve Yzerman, Chris Osgood, the list goes on and on. The Oilers would dispatch the Red Wings in 6 games. In the second round of the playoffs, the Oilers started the series 2 games down to San Jose and once again weren't given much of a chance. The Oilers would battle back, winning 4 in a row to knock the Sharks off in 6 games. The next round they would take Anaheim in 5 games to become the Western Conference champions and go on to the Stanley Cup against Carolina. Up until this point, Roloson had played in 18 playoff games, had a goals against average of 2.33 and a save percentage of .927. with 1 shutout and a 12-5 record. It was in Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final where the Oilers' fate was sealed. In the third period of a 4-4 Game 1, Andrew Ladd would collide with Roloson in the net, being pushed by Marc-Andre Bergeron. Roloson recalls that he felt like he had broke his arm in the fall, but when he tried to stand, it was evident that all the ligaments in his leg were torn. Ty Conklin came in to finish the game, and with 32 seconds left in the third period, a malfunction behind the net with Jason Smith saw Rob Brind'Amour walk out in front and score the winning goal. Jussi Markkanen was the starter from then on, and the Oilers even made it to Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals, but ultimately lost to the Carolina Hurricanes, earning them their first ever Stanley Cup. One thing I am 100% certain of is that if Dwayne Roloson had not gotten hurt in the first game of the Cup Finals, that the Oilers would have won in 05-06, easily. Going into the finals, he was the best goalie in the playoffs, and definitely a front-runner for the Conn Smythe Trophy, and was the Oilers' best shot at winning a Cup this century. It's overtime hockey, the way we're supposed to play. We throw a little lumber if a guy gets hit.